How is we going, retro people? My name is Brad, this is Retro Style Spotlight, and this is your news, notes, history, and retro games to play for the week of August 2nd, 2016. Last week's tutorial was all about the additional applications feature inside of Launchbox. This feature has existed within Launchbox for some time now, but I am starting to make my way down a list of features that users may be overlooking or may have never even heard of. Either way, I am sure some Launchbox vets will be able to get as much out of this tutorial as the newest of Launchbox users would as well. If you have a sweet spot for old computers like I do, then this is for you. There now exists a product called the Penultimate Cartridge for the Vic20, and it does some fantastic things. Produced by a UK company called The Future Was 8-Bit, this beauty is packing 40 ROMs into this cartridge to load up directly on the Vic20. That would be enough in some cases, but this cart also has on it RAM expansion for the computer, as well as an SD to IEC port that acts like a disk drive emulator, where you can load up thousands more ROMs. It does look like there is no regional American pricing, which is fine considering this is a primarily European venture and computer, but if you happen to have one of these and want to breathe some new life into it, like everyone seems to want to do with their old computers and consoles these days, then step right up and pre-order one of these for £65 sterling, which is about $85 at the time of this episode. I myself would love to start collecting old PCs like this, but money and space get in the way far too often, so I might need to settle on the portable versions of these older PCs first. Well, this is a first for RSS, a TV show. Specifically, Stranger Things on Netflix. Holy crap, is this show amazing. I watched it over this past weekend, and I am writing this on August 1st, so the weekend prior, and it was an amazing show. I generally don't believe the levels of parading that generally go on for products unless I myself come to the conclusion that I very much want it after watching or reading some coverage about it and trying to make an informed decision. Part of that was removed from the equation because it wasn't a sole project put out for purchase or even on actual TV channels, but rather it was just released out into the world. And since most people probably have a Netflix subscription, this fits right into the, well, I might as well territory. So I heard the Achievement Hunter guys talk about it on one of their podcasts over at Rooster Teeth, and I generally respect their opinions. Even then, I was like, well, people are different. I should probably read about it first. I promptly forgot. A few days later, browsing Netflix, and bam, Stranger Things was playing. At first, I felt like I was blown back into the 80s, and I got hints of Steven Spielberg and Stephen King almost immediately. I then proceeded to watch it all ASAP. This fits right into the RSS formula of being older and nostalgic to a lot of people, but it still is a new product released in 2016. The show was good. The show was damn good. Winona Ryder being in this probably shocked me the most. Every actor in this was good though, especially those kids. Those kids may be some of the best I've ever watched, period, of any child actor. So consider this my Stranger Things semi-review. Go watch it now. 80s period show set in Indiana, set in a mysterious world of sci-fi, adventuring and thrill. Think Super 8 dialed up to 100 and 4 times longer, but good every step of the way through it. I can't suggest this enough. Go watch this now. Speaking of Stranger Things, someone has mocked up the TV show to look like an old adventure game from the 90s. While this looks really awesome, and I would actually really want to see something like this made into a game, if you want something more actionable to go play that's very much in a similar vein to the TV show, I would suggest going to go play Cathy Rain, the Blackwell series of adventure games, the Chizo Mythos adventure games that starts with 5 Days a Stranger, and the upcoming Thimbleweed Park that I've previously covered here on RSS. While this does seem like somewhat of a publicity stunt that this person is pulling, trying to potentially raise attention for their adventure game, it's easy to see how the show would be transformed into a point-and-click adventure game if you've seen the show. There is an accompanying GIF and images for the real mock-up. However, I'm going to abstain from showing you the mock-up as it's very, very spoilerish if you haven't seen the show. If you've watched all 8 episodes, then click the link below to see the mock-up in action and let me know what you think of the show and the mock-up down in the comments below. This month in 1991, Nintendo releases the Super Nintendo alongside Super Mario World as the pack-in title in North America. Super Mario World, subtitled Super Mario Bros. 4 for its original Japanese release, is a 1990 platformer developed and published by Nintendo as a pack-in launch title for the SNES. Development was handled by Nintendo Entertainment Analysis and Development, led by Shigeru Miyamoto, who produced the game. It also features 2D graphics with linear transformations. The game centers on the quest of Mario and Luigi to save Dinosaur Land from Bowser, the series antagonist. The two brothers must travel across 7 worlds to restore order to Dinosaur Land. It built on the gameplay of previous Mario games, introducing new power-ups that augment character abilities and established conventions that were carried over to future games in the series. Super Mario World marks the first appearance of Yoshi, Mario's dinosaur sidekick, and riding mount. Super Mario World was a critically and commercial success, selling over 20 million copies worldwide, and is considered by many critics to be one of the best games ever made. It has been re-released 4 times, first as part of the combo with Super Mario All-Stars on the SNES in 1993. Secondly, it was released on the Game Boy Advance as Super Mario Advance 2 in 2001, and outside Japan as Super Mario World Super Mario Advance 2 in 2002, with modified gameplay. The third re-release was for the Wii's Virtual Console in Japan in 2006, and in North America and PAL regions in 2007. There were no changes from the original SNES version. It was also released for the Wii U Virtual Console, which integrated off-TV play and Miiverse features into the game, as well as the new Nintendo 3DS Virtual Console. So that was Retro Style Spotlight for the week of August 2nd, 2016. All the relevant links to everything you heard in this edition of RSS will be in the description below. Remember, you can sign up for a Launchbox Forum account to talk with us over there. If Launchbox has given you a beautiful library of games, then why not purchase a premium license of Launchbox for $20 to access Big Box, which is a controller and couch-oriented version of Launchbox. We also have our Launchbox games database now available for users to contribute to. If you have a few favorite games that are lacking in metadata or media, head on over to the games page on the database and make your desired edits or add the games yourself. Jason and I have a lot planned for our community, so if you haven't already subscribed to our YouTube channel, we're doing a tutorial video every Friday, live developer sessions, Q&As, and more entertainment type shows like this in the future. Let us know what you think of RSS and any feedback you may have on it. My name is Brad, the link to my channel is in the description below, and remember, freaks and geeks, to play more games, and we'll see you next time. Have a good day!